In this lesson, we'll be using the law of sines when given side-side angle to determine whether there are no possible triangles, one possible triangle, or two possible triangles. We won't actually be solving the triangles, we will just be determining the number of possible triangles. To do this, we'll find the first missing angle. If the sine function value is greater than 1, there's no possible triangle. If the sine function value is equal to 1, we have one right triangle. If the sine function value is less than 1, we'll find the first angle in quadrant 1, as well as the obtuse angle in quadrant 2. And then we'll check to see if the obtuse angle gives us a second possible triangle. The acute angle will always work. The obtuse angle will only work when the sum of the obtuse angle and the given angle is less than 180 degrees. Recall the sum of the interior angles of any triangle is 180 degrees. So if the sum of the two angles is greater than or equal to 180 degrees, there is no possible second triangle. For number one, we have the length of side A is 4, the length of side B is 5, angle B equals 47 degrees. Let's begin by determining the measure of angle A using the law of sines, which gives us the sine of A divided by the length of side A, which is 4, equals sine of angle B, which is the sine of 47 degrees, divided by the length of side B, which is 5. Next, we solve for sine A by multiplying both sides by 4. Simplifying, we now have sine A equals 4 sine 47 degrees divided by 5. And now to solve for A, we take the inverse sine of both sides of the equation. On the left, inverse sine of sine A equals A. We have A equals inverse sine of 4 sine 47 degrees divided by 5. And now we go to the calculator. Whichever calculator is used, it's important to make sure that it is in degree mode. This calculator is in degree mode. This is a Desmos scientific calculator. For inverse sine, click Functions, Inverse Sine, back to the main tab, 4 sine 47, close parenthesis, divided by 5, and enter. Rounding to one decimal place, we have A is approximately 35.8 degrees. So we know there's at least one possible triangle. Let's call this A sub 1. We now need to determine if there's a second possible obtuse angle for angle A. We'll call it A sub 2. To do this, let's first sketch 35.8 degrees in center position, which would be approximately here. Recall the sine function value is also positive in the second quadrant, so now we'll sketch an angle in the second quadrant with the same reference angle. Let's say here, the reference angle is 35.8 degrees, and the obtuse angle we need to check is this angle here that has the same sine function value. This would be 180 degrees minus the reference angle of 35.8 degrees, which is 144.2 degrees. We now need to check to see if angle A could also measure, this is rounded as well, 144.2 degrees. To check this, we need to add this angle to the given angle B, which is 47 degrees. In this case, notice 144.2 degrees plus 47 degrees is greater than or equal to 180 degrees, which means there is no possible second triangle. There's only one possible triangle, which is when A is approximately 35.8 degrees. So we'll go ahead and stop here. Number one, there's one possible triangle. If the sum of the obtuse angle and the given angle B was less than 180 degrees, there would be two possible triangles. And now let's take a look at number two. Length of side A is 3, the length of side C is 2, angle C equals 73 degrees. Let's again determine angle A. Using the law of sines, we have the sine of angle A divided by the length of side A, which is 3, equals the sine of C, which is a sine of 73 degrees, divided by the length of the side C, which is 2. Next, solve for sine A by multiplying both sides by 3. Simplifying, we have sine A equals 3 sine 73 degrees, all divided by 2. To solve for A, we take the inverse sine of both sides of the equation. Simplifying, inverse sine of sine A on the left is equal to A. We have A equals inverse sine of 3 sine 73 degrees divided by 2. And now we go back to the calculator. Functions, inverse sine, main tab, 3 sine 73, close parenthesis, divided by 2, and enter. Notice the angle is undefined, and this is because the sine function value, which is the quotient inside the inverse sine function, is greater than 1. This indicates there's no possible solution, or no possible triangle. And now let's take a look at number 3. Angle A equals 22 degrees. The length of side A is 4. The length of side B is 7. Let's begin by determining angle B. Using the law of sines, we have the sine of angle B divided by the length of side B, which is 7, equals the sine of angle A, which is the sine of 22 degrees, divided by the length of side A, which is 4. To solve for sine B, we multiply both sides by 7. Simplifying, we have sine B equals 7 sine 22 degrees divided by 4. And now we take the inverse sine of both sides to solve for B. Simplifying, inverse sine of sine B equals B, which is equal to inverse sine of 7 sine 22 degrees divided by 4. And we go back to the calculator one more time. Functions, inverse sine, main tab, 7 sine 22, close parenthesis, divided by 4, and enter. To one decimal place, because of the 6 we round up, which means the angle rounds to 41.0. So we know there's at least one triangle. We'll call this angle B sub 1. Let's check to see if there's also a second triangle where angle B could be angle B sub 2. Let's go ahead and sketch 41 degrees in standard position. So let's say 41.0 degrees is this angle here. We now need to find the obtuse angle in quadrant 2 that has the same sine function value, where the reference angle is the same, 41.0 degrees. 180 degrees minus 41.0 degrees is 139.0 degrees. So now we need to check to see if it's possible that angle B could also be approximately 139.0 degrees. To check this, we add angle B sub 2 to the given angle A. Notice 139.0 degrees plus 22 degrees is less than 180 degrees, which means we can form a second triangle where angle B is equal to 139 degrees, which indicates for number 3, there are 2 possible triangles. I hope you found this helpful.